When a doctor diagnoses cancer, it's the most shocking news a patient can hear. But there are hundreds of different types of cancer, some easier to deal with than others. But most patients don't understand the significance of which type of cancer they have. They just hear one word, cancer. The word they associate with unpleasant treatments and an early death. It's important to remember that most people beat their cancer. Wesley Kerr's met three survivors.
I remember waking up from the operation, deciding that I had beaten cancer. It had been cut away from me, it had gone. And I said to myself, I'm not going to waste a single day of my life.
I was quite an aggressive person in terms of my business and my lifestyle. I was typical superwoman, wife, mother, children, you know. And I had to let go of all that.
It has given me an inner strength. Having had the cancer, I think I take every day as it comes and I don't get too upset.
Bob Champion is now a successful trainer. At 30, he was a top jockey. A girlfriend noticed a lump on one of his testicles and insisted he see a doctor. He was diagnosed with cancer and given 8 months to live.
When I first was told I had cancer, all you ever read about was people that died of cancer. So I thought that was curtains for myself. And I thought, well, with a little bit of luck, I'll get killed in a novice chase. And it would be a nice way out.
At first, Bob Champion refused treatment, but doctors persuaded him to have surgery and chemotherapy.
I had one really bad spell when I got septicemia and I wanted to give up. And I found myself walking around the children's ward and seeing all these children having chemotherapy and not making any fuss about it. And I thought, well, if I'm not grown up enough, those children are. So I went back and started the treatment and got on with it.
Just as it is now, racing was his life. So he set himself the goal of winning the Grand National on his favourite horse.
Aldiniti was always a very unsound horse with an awful lot of leg problems throughout his career. But every time he came back from his treatments, he always seemed to win. And I thought, well, if the old horse can do it, why can't I?
They're coming to the final fence now in the National, and it's Aldiniti and Bob Champion in the lead. Aldiniti is going to win it. At the line, Aldiniti wins the National. Spartan Missile is second. Royal Mail is just...
Since Bob Champion had his cancer 20 years ago, treatments have improved dramatically, and so have the odds of survival. 60% of those diagnosed with breast cancer are healthy 5 years later, and 90% of those diagnosed with testicular cancer recover from it. Tina Cooke was convalescing after surgery for breast cancer when she was diagnosed with bone cancer. Given a 30% chance of survival, she went to Mexico to try alternative treatments. It was her way of coping. For her, it worked.
They showed me how to deal with my stress. I used to be a highly stressed person. I'm pretty relaxed now, I think. And they showed me how to eat properly, eat organic foods, try not to eat food that was contaminated with pesticides or hormones, and had lots of massage, which was very nice, and then very high doses of intravenous drips of vitamin C, hydrogen peroxide and selenium.
Over a year later, Tina Cooke's cancer is in remission. She still spends 3 hours a day sticking to her regime.
My husband said that he thought cancer changed me for the better, and it has, because I've become a much more relaxed person. I don't get stressed now if people turn on me. I spend a lot of time with my children, and it's not just quality time now, it's real time. And I look at things very differently.
At 60 years old, Diana Moran is as fit as she was in the 80s when she was the nation's sports mistress, the green goddess on the BBC's Breakfast Time. But in 1988, she was diagnosed with an aggressive form of breast cancer.
I was paying for the roof over my head by being physically fit and having a fairly attractive body shape. And suddenly, when I was told that I had cancer, the whole thing became a big trauma, because I thought not only was I losing, thinking I was going to lose my femininity, but I was also going to lose my livelihood. And that was very, very scary.
The cancer was so advanced, she had to have a double mastectomy, then surgery to reconstruct her breasts. But 3 months later, she was back at work.
The BBC had no idea this had happened to me, and I was doing a programme from Pebble Mill. I was taking the green men through a keep fit routine, and you'll never know how I steeled myself to do that. But I did it, and I came off air. I was just ebullient. I can't tell you how exciting it was. I've done it, I've got back, and I was okay. I think what got me through my treatment was the fact that I'm a quietly very determined person. People think I'm a bit sort of fluffy around the edges. Well, I might be, but I've got a very sort of solid core. And I've also got a wonderful family who are the strength to help me through it. I certainly feel that I've beaten my cancer.